I auditioned for this film once, and then I was going to audition for it again. At that time, they had cast Siddharth Malhotra. Hey guys, welcome to the Short Talk with me, Rohan. Mere saath mein hai, you know, Mirziya ka warrior, who has now become a superhero, Bhavesh Joshi, aka Harshvardhan Kapoor.
How's it going?
It's going great. It's our pleasure. So, to begin with, I'm going to call you Harsh. And yeah, I'm going to ask you about Bhavesh Joshi sabse pehle. Yeah, you were a Mirziya ka warrior. All of a sudden, why did you decide to become a superhero? Tell us.
So, what happened is I wanted to do this film for very long, actually.
Right.
Actually, I wanted this to be my first film.
Mm-hmm.
So, in 2012, I gave an audition for it. I was 21 at the time.
Okay.
And at the time, the script was quite different and I was very inexperienced as an actor.
Mm-hmm.
I hadn't done my first film, obviously, because I, you know, I was very young.
Right.
And then it didn't work out. You know, Vikram said, why don't you you go do a film or something and then, you know, maybe we can see later. And there was a lot of other casting things going on with the film.
Mm-hmm.
So anyway, long story short is I went and I did Mirziya. And for some reason, with two other actors, this film didn't take off.
Right.
And then I got lucky, and then in 2016, I met Vikram again.
Right.
And we kept in touch for about 4 years.
4 years, yeah.
And he said, why don't you show me rushes from Mirziya since you've almost finished shooting the film. So I said, you know, the film is quite unedited, and I don't know if that'll be fine. So I asked Rakesh, sir. I said, can you please show Vikram the rushes? And he did. And then Vikram saw them, and then we reopened this chapter, and now here we are.
So. Right. And the takeaway also is that no matter who you are, see, here's the man, he also had to give an audition, yeah.
A failed audition.
I auditioned for
this film once, and then I was going to audition for it again. At that time, they had cast Siddharth Malhotra.
Acha.
And then it happened. I've been wanting to do this film for 4 years before I signed it.
Okay, and how was the experience of working with Vikram Aditya Motwani? I believe he's a tough taskmaster.
Yeah, not easy to please.
Not easy
for sure.
To please.
Took me a long time to convince him that I was the right fit for the role. Got lucky. And then obviously we shot this film over 80 plus days, which is quite a lot.
Quite a lot.
Traditionally,
yeah.
Films are finished in 40-50 days, unless you're a really, really big film. And that was mainly because we had a very dense script.
Hmm.
But yeah, with him, every day on set, you have to give 110%.
Hmm.
He never settles for anything less. And when you give him that and you commit to him and you give him what he wants, then he will surprise you with the results.
Okay.
He will take you beyond your potential and the performance will be better than you thought or expected because that's how good he is.
Okay.
You know? So if I'm good in this film, it's only because of him and my co-actors.
Wow.
Because my co-actors in this film, there's some new actors.
Mm-hmm.
There's Priyanshu,
right.
There's Ashish Verma, Shreya Sabarwal, Nishikant Kamat is there.
Nishikant Kamat is there.
And they're such fine actors that they've actually elevated my work. You know, I truly believe that I'm nowhere compared to any of these guys. You'll see them in the film, they're all amazing. So,
did it ever happen on set? You told Nishikant Kamat, "Acha, ugly film, let's do it together." Now that you're also acting
so
with me and you're seeing my work and how dedicated I am.
So, he's a great director.
Right.
He's made some really successful films. Drishyam.
Yeah. Without doubt. Mumbai Meri Jaan.
All of that. So, we had a couple of scenes where we were waiting. You know, for the light or the camera and stuff. So we talked a lot about films and films he was making and stuff. Yeah, but I'd love to collaborate with him. He's a really cool guy.
Okay. So you've worked with, you know, a very different director in Mirziya, and now then there is Vikram Aditya Motwani. Dono ka jo school of thought, I like to say, or the way of working is very different. So what is the biggest difference that, you know, you kind of saw ke achha udhar aisa tha, now here it's like completely different?
Many, many big differences that I'll tell you about. But one big difference was speed. Because Rakesh Mehra is somebody that likes to take a lot of time. He takes his time, he likes to do things at his own pace.
Right.
You know, so Mirziya, we had a very large budget.
Correct.
Especially for a newcomer film.
Correct.
And, you know, the film may not have completely worked, but in terms of a visual, musical extravaganza, it was right up there.
Yeah, it is poetry.
It is poetry in motion, you know. So to kind of, compose those shots and, you know, to kind of get it all to kind of work, it took time. So we would sometimes shoot one scene a day, one and a half scene a day. With Bhavesh Joshi, we didn't have a big budget. We had quite a small budget and we wanted to do a lot. So we would shoot three, sometimes four scenes a day.
Okay.
And we would also shoot action, you know, and we would shoot day and then days going into nights.
Okay.
So it was, you know, Vikram always tells me that if we had a bigger budget and shot this film Bollywood style, we would have taken 110, 120 days.
Wow, that's like 4 months.
Yeah, so we condensed that. So pace of working, also with Rakesh Om Prakash Mehra, there's a lot of preparation and going into shoot knowing exactly what you're going to do. Here it's a lot of improvisation, a lot of doing new things on the spot. So that helped. I was initially very scared, but it opened me up a lot as an actor, and I truly believe that Vikram has made me a better
so
actor.
When you say you were scared, what were you really like scared about?
You know, I was scared about, you know, what he, so like Vikram would, for example, I would be preparing for a scene for many months and he would I would show up on set fully prepared, and then he would write a brand new scene. Like two hours before the shoot. And this huge monologue, okay, and give it to me in my hand. And I'm like, but I've not. So he's like, so what, you're an actor, you'll do it.
So, you know, Harsh, my next question is that you were 21, like you said, 2012, mein you gave the audition for the first time. And, you know, superhero, Vikramaditya Motwane, maybe the Phantom brand. So, you know, of course, and the script was also very different. But when you signed the film again, or when you wanted to do it again, what was the real reason? Like, what about the change script story did you want, like, that you wanted to do the film?
So, when I read the script first in 2012, it was actually quite different. It was about land grabbing.
Achha.
And about how people, you know, land grab and they build buildings on it, and about how Bombay is kind of becoming a concrete jungle.
Right.
Now it's about something completely different. And there was just so much sincerity and honesty in the script. It felt like a film that was very personal to Vikramaditya Motwane. And it was written by Vikram and Anurag, who I believe are probably the best writing team in India.
I think.
So I mean, Anurag's command over the Hindi language.
Correct.
And Vikram's mind. And it was also not just a Vikramaditya Motwane film, it was Vikramaditya Motwane's most ambitious film.
Right.
You know, because I mean, Udaan, Trap, these are great films, but they're proper independent films. They're smaller films.
Right.
Lutera is the one big film.
Big film. Yes.
But I think in terms of what he wants to achieve with this, this has always been his dream film. And it just read so well, you know, that I became obsessed with the idea of doing it.
Okay. So Bhavesh Joshi was a superhero, but you're also common man in the film.
Yeah, completely. Right?
So what was your approach to the character?
You know, I don't think there's always, there's no like one thing that, you know, I'm going to do this and then I'm suddenly going to become the character. I think it's like taking baby steps. I think it happens over a period of time. You know, I think you go scene by scene, you make some important choices. So I have a roommate in the film who's played by Priyanshu.
Priyanshu, right.
So Priyanshu and I, we decided to stay together in the same house. So I moved out of my house and Priyanshu and I stayed together. That brought us very close, and that reflects in the film when you see us together, because you feel like we've been friends.
So that's the real dosti yari, so to speak.
Yeah, there is full dosti yari. It's got those that Rang De Basanti vibe in a way.
Okay, you know, that's interesting.
Which is, I mean, it is. That is all. That's a film about male bonding. So is Kai Poche.
Right.
So those threads are kind of there in the film. It's about these three friends. Three or four friends.
On that note, thank you so much.
Thanks, man.
It's been a pleasure.
Thanks for having me again.
Thank you.